My experience personally and what I've observed for myself is that Scientology is destructive and a ripoff, and that it's very, very dangerous for your spiritual, psychological, mental, emotional health.
Everybody has a right to believe what they want to believe, but I don't believe that anybody has a right to trick anybody, to hurt anybody, to harm somebody for their own purposes.
This is a 13-year-old boy?
Yeah, he would be 13. He was 12 when he started. I'm full-time staff.
Full-time staff? Full-time work?
Yes.
What sort of work is a child of that age doing at the Church of Scientology?
Mostly clerical or admin type of work.
This 13-year-old boy is one of 8 children we filmed on various weekdays over several weeks. While most children are starting school, these children arrive at the Church of Scientology to start...
He's in there to start a day of work.
Start a full day of work?
That's right.
What sort of...
That's what they do 5 days a week.
What sort of tutoring, homeschooling is he getting in there?
He's supposed to be getting homeschooling for, I think it's 3 hours a day, 5 days a week, but he's not getting any.
Our source recently left Scientology after several years on staff and says he felt compelled to speak out for these children.
ExScientologyKids.com was created by 3 young women who used to be members of the church. One of the women stands out from the crowd of online critics. That's because on the family tree of Scientology, she's rooted in deep. She is a niece of leader David Miscavige. Jenna Miscavige Hill was raised in the church. Both her parents were high-ranking members of what's called the Sea Organization, or Sea Org. It is Scientology's version of the clergy, the group of people who essentially run the church.
What we're told is that they have to work so hard because they're helping other people. Your family isn't the most important thing. We lived in dormitories, and I would only see my parents once a week.
According to Jenna, life as a child was not very childlike.
It was like 6:30, wake up, you'd put on your uniform, somebody would stand in front and they would go to each line and they'd be like, Unit A, report. If you were late, you would get a chit, which would go to your ethics file, which they had one for everyone. One time a kid got a bucket of ice water dumped on top of his head when he was late.
Jenna says when she was 7, she was asked to sign a billion-year contract to prove her devotion to the church.
In Scientology, they believe that you live lifetime after lifetime.
At age 12, Jenna left California for a visit to the church's so-called Mecca in Clearwater, Florida. She says church elders asked her to remain there and become a full-fledged member of the Sea Org, while her parents remained in California.
I wanted to go back and see them, and I was even about to get on a plane, and I just got pulled into a room and screamed at.
At 12 years old, Jenna says life at Clearwater consisted of long days studying academics and Scientology and hours of administrative tasks and chores. Sometimes, Jenna says, they worked through the night.
You don't sign up for the nights, or you stay up all night, sleep 2 hours, stay up all night, the next night, sleep 2 hours.
See, now it ain't a joke for me when you start talking about this. This is the bad stuff. What they, you know, do to recruit. Shit, actors is one thing. What about the little children they get into the Sea Organization? Billionaire contract. You know, you hear my story. And I got out and I've got some sad tales and maybe I got ripped off for a good chunk of money and this, that, and the other thing. If you look at that as compared to somebody who joins the Sea Org, it's not even comparable. Can you imagine what it would be like to have a person at your beck and call and complete disposal, your slave, who not only was a slave by force, but by you know, you've got them by the mind, not the balls. You got them by the mind. 100 hours probably is what the average Sea Org person works a week. I'd say about 80 to 100 hours a week. And then you get that for 50 years, 40 years, because they get them when they're teenagers. I mean, that's taking people's lives away. That's enslaving somebody's mind.
I was a Sea Org member for 10 years. I was in the ship for 8 years. I was in Los Angeles. And I wanted to give this message to you guys in the Sea Org from a guy who's out for 4 years. You guys have seen these people on the RPF, on a slave camp, you know, taking all their rights away. They can't talk. They can't, you know, they can't talk to anybody unless they've been spoken to. They get terrible food. They get no pay. They get no free time for years and years. I knew people who were on the RPF for 7 years. Main thing I want to say is, hey, you don't have to live with no freedoms, you know. I mean, when you're out, you can go on a date, you can go out, you can watch a movie, you can go anywhere you want. You don't have to wait for liberty. You can do these things. You know, you can see your family whenever you want. You can go see your mother. Like, I'm going to see my mother next week up in Kingston. Great, you know. I couldn't do that when I was in the Sea Org. I didn't see her for 6-7 years at a time. If, you know, if the second dynamic is so important, why don't they let you see your family?
I saw my mom probably a half an hour one time from when I was 12 till I was 16. I saw my dad maybe 3 times for a half an hour each time from 12 till I was 16.
You know, I know what it's like to be staff, and I know what it's like to deep down be thinking, oh my God, I just can't do this. You know, most of these people are good people. They just have no idea what's going on. They just, if they knew half of what was going on, they would be out. They think they're doing something good, but they're not. They're not. They're deceived by a lot.
When I was 14, I was recruited to join this organization. They made it sound so wonderful.
Like Jenna, Astra Woodcraft was the daughter of Scientologists and as a child went to Scientology schools. Her workday consisted of studying, mostly L. Ron Hubbard's teachings, and clerical duties.
I worked, you know, 15 hours a day. We worked 7 days a week. I maybe had 2 or 3 days off a year.
Astra says disobedience wasn't tolerated in the Sea Org. She says once she refused an order from a higher-ranking Sea Org member.
And he held me up against a wall, screaming in my face.
Astra's father, Lawrence, wanted out. He says he felt that wasn't an option.
You'll be declared a suppressive person and then you'll never speak to your family again.
Leave without permission, they declare you a suppressive person and they make your family and all your friends, anyone in Scientology who knows you, they make them disconnect from you. They came out with a new rule. They said, that's it, no more kids.
And she was very upset when she was about 16 or 17 and said they suddenly decided to change the rules and that, you know, Sea Org members were no longer allowed to have children.
If you get pregnant when you're in the Sea Org, you either have to leave or you get an abortion. I know people who have gotten like up to 4 abortions.
I remember thinking, well, wait a minute, I never agreed to this. You know, I'm like 17 years old. I haven't made a decision. I'm not going to have children.
2 years after the policy was established, Astra learned she and her husband were expecting a baby.
A very high-level Sea Org member saw me one day and asked me what I was doing, and I said that I was leaving. And he said, why? And I said, I'm pregnant. And he said, oh, is it too late for an abortion? In like such a callous way, I didn't even know what to say.